This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Norfolk Island In, ˈnɔərfək Ailen7, Norfuk, Norfolk Island is a small island in the Pacific Ocean located between Australia, New Zealand, and New Caledonia, 1,412 kilometres 877. 1 History 11 Early History 12 19th Century 13 Post 19th Century 14 Reduced Autonomy 2016 2 Geography 21 Gallery 22 Climate 23 Environment 231 Flora 232 Fauna 3 Demographics 31 Statistics 4 Culture 5 Government and Politics 51 Constitutional Status 52 Immigration and Citizenship 53 Health Care 54 Defense and Law Enforcement 55 Courts 56 Census 57 Postal Service 6 Economy and Infrastructure 61 Taxes 62 Communications 63 Transport 7 See also 8 References 9 Notes 10 Further Reading 11 External Links History Main Article, History of Norfolk Island Early History Norfolk Island was settled by East Polynesian seafarers either from the Kermadec Islands north of New Zealand or from the North Island of New Zealand they arrived in the 13th or 14th century, and survived for several generations before disappearing. The first European known to have sighted and landed on the island was Captain James Cook, on 10 October 1774, on his second voyage to the South Pacific on HMS Resolution. He named it after Mary Howard, Duchess of Norfolk. C. 1712–1773 Sir John Call argued the advantages of Norfolk Island in that it was uninhabited and that New Zealand flax grew there. In 1786 the British government included Norfolk Island as an auxiliary settlement, as proposed by John Call. In its plan for colonisation of New South Wales, the decision to settle Norfolk Island was taken due to Empress Catherine II of Russia's decision to restrict sales of hemp. Practically all the hemp and flax required by the Royal Navy for cordage and sailcloth was imported from Russia when the First Fleet arrived at Port Jackson in January 1788. Governor Arthur Phillip ordered Lieutenant Philip Gidley King to lead a party of 15 convicts and 7 free men to take control of Norfolk Island and prepare for its commercial development. They arrived on 6 March 1788 during the first year of the settlement, which was also called Sydney. Like its parent, more convicts and soldiers were sent to the island from New South Wales' 19th century Norfolk Island jail. As early as 1794, Lieutenant Governor of New South Wales Francis Gross suggested its closure as a penal settlement, as it was too remote and difficult for shipping and too costly to maintain. The first group of people left in February 1805, and by 1808 only about 200 remained, forming a small settlement until the remnants were removed in 1813. A small party remained to slaughter stock and destroy all buildings, so that there would be no inducement for anyone, especially from other European powers, to visit and lay claim to the place. From the 15th of February 1814 to the 6th of June 1825 the island was abandoned. In 1824 the British government instructed the Governor of New South Wales, Thomas Brisbane, to occupy Norfolk Island as a place to send the worst description of convicts. Its remoteness, previously seen as a disadvantage, was now viewed as an asset for the detention of recalcitrant male prisoners. The convicts detained have long been assumed to be a hardcore of recidivists, or doubly convicted capital respites, that is, men transported to Australia who committed fresh colonial crimes for which they were sentenced to death, and were spared the gallows on condition of life at Norfolk Island. However, a recent study has demonstrated, utilising a database of 6,458 Norfolk Island convicts, that the reality was somewhat different. More than half were detained at Norfolk Island without ever receiving a colonial conviction, and only 15% had been reprieved from a death sentence. Furthermore, the overwhelming majority of convicts sent to Norfolk Island had committed non-violent property sentences, and the average length of detention was 3 years. The second penal settlement began to be wound down by the British government after 1847, and the last convicts were removed to Tasmania in May 1855. The island was abandoned because transportation from the United Kingdom to Van Diemen's Land, Tasmania, had ceased in 1853, to be replaced by penal servitude in the UK on 8 June 1856. The next settlement began on Norfolk Island. These were the descendants of Tahitians and the HMS Bounty mutineers, including those of Fletcher culture Christian, they resettled from the Pitcairn Islands, which had become too small for their growing population. On 3 May 1856, 193 persons left Pitcairn Islands aboard Morayshire. On 8 June 194 persons arrived, a baby having been born in transit. The Pitcairners occupied many of the buildings remaining from the penal settlements, and gradually established traditional farming and whaling industries on the island. Although some families decided to return to Pitcairn in 1858 and 1863, the island's population continued to grow. They accepted additional settlers, who often arrived with whaling fleets in 1867. The headquarters of the Melanesian Mission of the Church of England was established on the island in 1920. The mission was relocated from Norfolk Island to the Solomon Islands to be closer to the population of focus. Norfolk Island was the subject of several experiments in administration during the century. It began the 19th century as part of the colony of New South Wales. On 29 September 1844, Norfolk Island was transferred out of the colony of New South Wales to the colony of Van Diemen's Land. On 1 November 1856, Norfolk Island was separated from the colony of Tasmania, formerly Van Diemen's Land, and constituted as a distinct and separate settlement, the affairs of which should, until further order in that behalf by Her Majesty, be administered by a governor to be for that purpose appointed. The Governor of New South Wales was constituted as the Governor of Norfolk Island on 19 March 1897. The office of the Governor of Norfolk Island was abolished, and responsibility for the administration of Norfolk Island was vested in the Governor of the Colony of New South Wales. Yet, the island was not made a part of New South Wales, it remained separate. The Colony of New South Wales ceased to exist upon the establishment of the Commonwealth of Australia on 1 January 1901, and from that date responsibility for the administration of Norfolk Island was vested in the Governor of the State of New South Wales. Post-19th century, the island was placed under the authority of the Commonwealth of Australia in 1914 by an order in council made in the United Kingdom pursuant to the Australian Waste Lands Act, 1855 of the United Kingdom. The Parliament of the Commonwealth of Australia had already accepted the territory by the Norfolk Island Act, 1913 of Australia. During World War II, the island became a key airbase and refueling depot between Australia and New Zealand, and New Zealand and the Solomon Islands. The airstrip was constructed by Australian, New Zealand and United States servicemen during 1942. Since Norfolk Island fell within New Zealand's area of responsibility, it was garrisoned by a New Zealand Army unit known as N-Force at a large army camp which had the capacity to house a 1,500-strong force. N-Force relieved a company of the 2nd Australian Imperial Force. The island proved too remote to come under attack during the war, and N-Force left the island in February 1944. In 1979, Norfolk was granted limited self-government by Australia, under which the island elected a government that ran most of the island's affairs. In 2006, a formal review process took place, in which the Australian government considered revising this model of government. The review was completed on 20 December 2006, when it was decided that there would be no changes in the governance of Norfolk Island. Financial problems and a reduction in tourism led to Norfolk Island's administration appealing to the Australian federal government for assistance in 2010. In return, the islanders were to pay income tax for the first time but would be eligible for greater welfare benefits. However, by May 2013, agreement had not been reached and islanders were having to leave to find work and welfare. An agreement was finally signed in Canberra on 12 March 2015 to replace self-government with a local council, but against the wishes of the Norfolk Island government. A majority of Norfolk Islanders have objected to the Australian plan to make changes to Norfolk Island without first consulting them and allowing their say, with 68% of voters against forced changes. On 4 October 2015, Norfolk Island changed its time zone from UTC 11:30 to UTC 11 o'clock. Reduced autonomy. 2016. In March 2015, the Australian government announced comprehensive reforms for Norfolk Island. The action was justified on the grounds it was necessary to address issues of sustainability which have arisen from the model of self-government requiring Norfolk Island to deliver local, state and federal functions since 1979. On 17 June 2015, the Norfolk Island Legislative Assembly was abolished, with the territory becoming run by an administrator and an advisory council. Elections for a new regional council were held on 28 May 2016, with the new council taking office on 1 July 2016. From that date, most Australian Commonwealth laws extend to Norfolk Island. This means that taxation, social security, immigration, customs and health arrangements apply on the same basis as in mainland Australia. Travel travel between Norfolk Island and mainland Australia became domestic travel on 1 July 2016. Department of Infrastructure and Regional Development, Factsheet, Domestic Travel between Norfolk Island and mainland Australia, website accessed on 12 November 2016. Norfolk Island residents also became eligible to vote in the ACT electorate of Canberra. Significant opposition to the reforms has arisen in the territory led by Norfolk Island People for Democracy Inc., an association appealing to the United Nations to include the island on its list of non-self-governing territories. Geography view across to Nepean Island foreground and Phillip Island map of Norfolk Island. Norfolk Island is located in the South Pacific Ocean, east of the Australian mainland. Norfolk Island is the main island of the island group the territory encompasses and is located at 29 degrees 02 S 167 degrees 57 E 29,033 degrees south 167,950 degrees east, -29,033, 167,950. It has an area of 346 square kilometers 134 of Kingston. There are no safe harbor facilities on Norfolk Island, with loading jetties existing at Kingston and Cascade Bay. All goods not domestically produced are brought in by ship, usually to Cascade Bay. Emily Bay, protected from the Pacific Ocean by a small coral reef, is the only safe area for recreational swimming, although surfing waves can be found at Anson and Ball Bays. The climate is subtropical and mild, with little seasonal differentiation. The island is the eroded remnant of a basaltic volcano active around 23-3. Road, where the shopping centre, post office, bottle shop, telephone exchange and community hall are located. Settlement also exists over much of the island, consisting largely of widely separated homesteads. Government House, the official residence of the administrator, is located on Quality Row in what was the penal settlement of Kingston. Other government buildings, including the court, legislative assembly and administration, are also located there. Kingston's role is largely a ceremonial one, however, with most of the economic impetus coming from burnt Pine Gallery. Anson Bay on Norfolk Island. Captain Cook Lookout within the Norfolk Island National Park. Anson Bay, an attractive tourist spot. St. Barnabas Anglican Church. Climate. Norfolk Island has a marine subtropical climate. Köppen climate classification, CFA, which is best characterized as mild. The temperature almost never falls below 10 August. Other months receive significant amounts of precipitation as well. Climate data for Norfolk Island Airport. Month: January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. Year record: high degree C degree F 283.829 sextillion 284 quintillion 831 quartillion 284 trillion 831 duodecillion 266 undecillion 799 decillion 251 nonillion 772 octillion 234 septillion 741 sextillion 220 quintillion 716 quadrillion 218 trillion 712 billion 238,748,244 759 quintillion 265 quadrillion 797 trillion 282 billion 828 million 284,831 average high degree C degree F 245 octillion 761 septillion 249 sextillion 768 quintillion 243 quadrillion 757 trillion 227 billion 729 million 693 quatuordecillion 667 tritacillion 184 duodecillion 651 undecillion 183 decillion 649 nonillion 190 octillion 662 septillion 202 sextillion 684 quintillion 217 quadrillion 711 trillion 234 billion 741 million 215,707 average low degree C degree F 191. 586-161-61-178-64-163-613 Record low degree C degree F 121-538-128-55-121-538-97-495-66-439. 71-448-62-432-67-441-77-459-82-468-87-477-114-525-62-432 Average precipitationum inches
866-338-1018-408-1238-4874-132-0-5197-1463-576-1418-5583-1272-5008-943-3713-849
33437282866-857-3374-1-2902-50795 Average precipitation days 109 octillion 122 septillion 150 sextillion 158 quintillion 185 quadrillion 197 trillion 209 billion 191,149,128
102-112-1812
Mean monthly sunshine hours 2325-2065-2065-1829-1560-1829-2046-213-0-2294-2370-2387-2 4741 Source, Bureau of Meteorology Environment Flora Rapalostylus Bowery, a native palm. Norfolk Island has 174 native plants, 51 of them are endemic. At least 18 of the endemic species are rare or threatened. The Norfolk Island palm Rapalostylus Bowery and the smooth tree fern Cyathea brownii, the tallest tree fern in the world, are common in the Norfolk Island National Park but rare elsewhere on the island before European colonization. Most of Norfolk Island was covered with subtropical rainforest, the canopy of which was made of Araucaria heterophylla Norfolk Island pine in exposed areas, and the palm Rapalostylus bowery and tree ferns Cyathea brownii and C. australis in moisture-protected areas. The understory was thick with lianas and ferns covering the forest floor. Only one small tract 5. Island fauna. As a relatively small and isolated oceanic island, Norfolk has few land birds but a high degree of endemicity among them. Many of the endemic species and subspecies have become extinct as a result of massive clearance of the island's native vegetation of subtropical rainforest for agriculture, hunting and persecution as agricultural pests. The birds have also suffered from the introduction of mammals such as rats, cats, pigs and goats, as well as from introduced competitors such as common blackbirds and crimson rosellas. Extinction include that of the endemic Norfolk caca and Norfolk ground dove, along with endemic subspecies of pigeon, starling, triller, thrush and boobook owl, though the latter's genes persist in a hybrid population descended from the last female. Other endemic birds are the white-chested white-eye, which may be extinct, the Norfolk parakeet, the Norfolk jerrigone, the slender-billed white-eye and endemic subspecies of the Pacific robin and golden whistler. The Norfolk Island group Nepean Island is also home to breeding seabirds. The Providence petrel was hunted to local extinction by the beginning of the 19th century, but has shown signs of returning to breed on Phillip Island. Other seabirds breeding there include the white-necked petrel, kermadec petrel, wedge-tailed shearwater, Australasian gannet, red-tailed tropicbird, and grey ternlet. The sooty tern, known locally as the whale bird, has traditionally been subject to seasonal egg harvesting by Norfolk Islanders. Norfolk Island, with neighbouring Nepean Island, has been identified by BirdLife International as an important bird area because it supports the entire populations of white-chested and slender-billed white-eyes, Norfolk parakeets and Norfolk jerrigones, as well as over 1% of the world populations of wedge-tailed shearwaters and red-tailed tropicbirds. Nearby Phillip Island is treated as a separate IBA. Norfolk Island also has a botanical garden, which is home to a sizable variety of plant species. However, the island has only one native mammal, Gold's wattled bat Chalonolobus goldii. It is very rare, and may already be extinct on the island. The Norfolk swallowtail Papilio amanther is a species of butterfly that is found on Norfolk Island, and the Loyalty Island cetaceans were historically abundant around the island as commercial hunts on the island was operating until 1956. Today, numbers of larger whales have disappeared, but even today many species such humpback whale, mink whale, sei whale, and dolphins can be observed close to shore, and scientific surveys have been conducted regularly. Southern right whales were once regular migrants to Norfolk, but were severely depleted by historical hunts, and further by recent illegal Soviet and Japanese whaling, resulting in none or very few, if remnants. Still live, right whales in these regions along with Lord Howe Island whale sharks can be encountered off the island, two gannet-masked boobies white tern Emily Bay Norfolk Island pines Captain Cook Lookout Bird Rock off the North Coast Cathedral Rock off the North Coast Demographics. The resident population of Norfolk Island in the 2011 census was 1,796, which had declined from a high of 2,601 in 2001. This was 78% of the census count, with the remaining 22% being visitors. 16% of the population were 14. Ancestry, being descendants of the bounty mutineers as well as more recent arrivals from Australia and New Zealand. About half of the islanders can trace their roots back to Pitcairn Island. This common heritage has led to a limited number of surnames among the islanders, a limit constraining enough that the island's telephone directory also includes nicknames for many subscribers, such as Cane Toad, Dar Busybee, Lettuce Leaf, Goof, Paw Paw, Diddles, Rubber Duck, Carrots and Tarzan. 62% of islanders are Christians. After the death of the first chaplain Rev. G. H. Nobbs in 1884, a Methodist church was formed, and in 1891 a Seventh-day Adventist congregation led by one of Nobbs' sons. Some unhappiness with G. H. Nobbs, the more organized and formal ritual of the Church of England service arising from the influence of the Melanesian mission, decline in spirituality, the influence of visiting American whalers, literature sent by Christians overseas impressed by the Pitcairn story, and the adoption of Seventh-day Adventism by the descendants of the mutineers still on Pitcairn, all contributed to these developments. The Roman Catholic Church began work in 1957, and in the late 1990s a group left the former Methodist then Uniting Church and formed a Charismatic Fellowship in 2011, 34% of the ordinary residents identified as Anglican, 13% as Uniting Church, 12% as Roman Catholic and 3% as Seventh-day Adventist. 9% were from other religions. 24% had no religion, and 7% did not indicate a religion. Typical ordinary congregations in any church do not exceed 30 local residents as of 2010. The three older denominations have good facilities. Ministers are usually short-term visitors. Literacy is not recorded officially, but can be assumed to be roughly at a par with Australia's literacy rate, as islanders attend a school which uses a New South Wales curriculum, before traditionally moving to the mainland for further study. Islanders speak both English and a Creole language known as Norfuk, a blend of 18th-century English and Tahitian. The Norfuk language is decreasing in popularity as more tourists travel to the island and more young people leave for work and study reasons. However, there are efforts to keep it alive via dictionaries and the renaming of some tourist attractions to their Norfuk equivalents. In 2004, an act of the Norfolk Island Assembly made it a co-official language of the island. The act is long titled, an act to recognize the Norfolk Island language Norfolk as an official language of Norfolk Island. The language known as Norfolk is described as the language that is spoken by descendants of the first free settlers of Norfolk Island, who were descendants of the settlers of Pitcairn Island. The Act recognizes and protects use of the language but does not require it. In official use, it must be accompanied by an accurate translation into English. 32% of the total population reported speaking a language other than English in the 2011 census, and just under three-quarters of the ordinarily resident population could speak Norfolk. Emigration is growing as many islanders take advantage of the close ties between Norfolk and Australia and New Zealand. The sole school on the island, Norfolk Island Central School, provides education from kindergarten through to year 12. The school has a contractual arrangement referred to as a Memorandum of Understanding with the New South Wales Department of Education and Communities regarding the teaching staff of the school, the latest of which took effect in January 2015. In 2015, enrollment at the Norfolk Island Central School was 282 students. No public tertiary education infrastructure exists on the island. The Norfolk Island Central School works in partnership with registered training organization RTOs and local employers to support students accessing vocational education and training VET courses. The small economy of the island causes many skilled workers to emigrate as well. Statistics. The following demographic statistics are from the CIA World Factbook. Population 2210. Population growth rate 0.01%. Nationality Norfolk Islanders noun Norfolk Islanders adjective ethnic groups Australian 795% New Zealander 133% Fijian 25% Filipino 11% English 1% other 18% unspecified 08% religions Protestant 496% Anglican 318% Uniting Church in Australia 106% Seventh-day Adventist 32% Roman Catholic 117% other 86% None 235% unspecified 66% languages English official 676% other 324% includes Norfolk Island 237%, which is a mixture of 18th century English and ancient Tahitian culture while there was no indigenous culture on the island at the time of settlement, the Tahitian influence of the Pitcairn settlers has resulted in some aspects of Polynesian culture being adapted to that of Norfolk, including the hula dance local cuisine also shows influences from the same region Islanders traditionally spend a lot of time outdoors, with fishing and other aquatic pursuits being common pastimes, an aspect which has become more noticeable as the island becomes more accessible to tourism most island families have at least one member involved in primary production in some form view across to Phillip Island as all the Pitcairn settlers were related to each other, Islanders have historically been informal both to each other and to visitors the most noticeable aspect of this is the Norfolk wave, with drivers waving to each other ranging from a wave using the entire arm through to a raised index finger from the steering wheel as they pass religious observance remains an important part of life for some islanders, particularly the older generations, but actual attendance is about 8% of the resident population plus some tourists in the 2006 census 199% had no religion compared with 132% in 1996 businesses are closed on Wednesday and Saturday afternoons and Sundays One of the island's residents was the novelist Colleen McCullough, whose works include The Thorn Birds and the Masters of Rome series as well as Morgan's Run, set, in large part, on Norfolk Island. Helen Reddy also moved to the island for a period, and still maintains a house there. American novelist James A. Michener, who served in the United States Navy during World War II, set one of the chapters of his episodic novel Tales of the South Pacific on Norfolk Island. The island is one of the few locations outside North America to celebrate the holiday of Thanksgiving. Government and politics main article, Politics of Norfolk Island Norfolk Island is the only non-mainland Australian territory to have had self-governance the Norfolk Island Act 1979, passed by the Parliament of Australia in 1979, is the act under which the island was governed until the passing of the Norfolk Island Legislation Amendment Act 2015. The Australian government maintains authority on the island through an administrator, currently Gary Hardgrave from 1979 to 2015. A legislative assembly was elected by popular vote for terms of not more than 3 years, although legislation passed by the Australian Parliament could extend its laws to the territory at will, including the power to override any laws made by the Assembly. The Assembly consisted of 9 seats, with electors casting 9 equal votes, of which no more than 2 could be given to any individual candidate. It is a method of voting called a weighted first-past-the-post system. 4 of the members of the Assembly formed the Executive Council, which devised policy and acted as an advisory body to the administrator. The last Chief Minister of Norfolk Island was Lyle Snell. Other ministers included, Minister for Tourism, Industry and Development, Minister for Finance, Minister for Cultural Heritage and Community Services, and Minister for Environment. All seats were held by independent candidates. Norfolk Island did not embrace party politics in 2007. A branch of the Australian Labor Party was formed on Norfolk Island, with the aim of reforming the system of government since July 2016 after the loss of self-government, residents of Norfolk Island have been required to enrol in the Division of Canberra as is the case for all Australian citizens. Enrolment and voting for Norfolk Islanders is compulsory. Disagreements over the island's relationship with Australia were put in sharper relief by a 2006 review undertaken by the Australian government under the more radical of two models proposed in the review. The island's legislative assembly would have been reduced to the status of a local council however, in December 2006, citing the significant disruption that changes to the governance would impose on on the island's economy. The Australian government ended the review, leaving the existing governance arrangements unaltered in a move that apparently surprised many islanders. The Chief Minister of Norfolk Island, David Buffett, announced on 6 November 2010 that the island would voluntarily surrender its self-government status in return for a financial bailout from the federal government to cover significant debts. It was announced on 19 March 2015 that self-governance for the island would be revoked by the Commonwealth and replaced by a local council, with the state of New South Wales providing services to the island. A reason given was that the island had never gained self-sufficiency and was being heavily subsidised by the Commonwealth. By $125 million in 2015 alone, it meant that residents would have to start paying Australian income tax, but they would also be covered by Australian welfare schemes such as Centrelink and Medicare. The Norfolk Island Legislative Assembly decided to hold a referendum on the proposal on 8 May 2015. Voters were asked if Norfolk Islanders should freely determine their political status and their economic, social and cultural development, and to be consulted at referendum or plebiscite on the future model of governance for Norfolk Island before such changes are acted upon by the Australian Parliament. 68% out of 912 voters voted in favour. The Norfolk Island Chief Minister, Lyle Snell, said that the referendum results blow a hole in Canberra's assertion that the reforms introduced before the Australian Parliament that propose abolishing the Legislative Assembly and Norfolk Island Parliament were overwhelmingly supported by the people of Norfolk Island. The Norfolk Island Legislation Amendment Bill 2015 passed the Australian Parliament on 14 May 2015, assented on 26 May 2015, abolishing self-government on Norfolk Island and transferring Norfolk Island into a council as part of New South Wales law from 1 July 2016. Norfolk Island legislation will be transferred to New South Wales and subject to NSW legislation. The island's official capital is Kingston. It is, however, more a centre of government than a sizeable settlement. The largest settlement is at Burnt Pine. The most important local holiday is Bounty Day, celebrated on 8 June, in memory of the arrival of the Pitcairn Islanders in 1856. Local ordinances and acts apply on the island, where most laws are based on the Australian legal system. Australian common law applies when not covered by either Australian or Norfolk Island law. Suffrage is universal at age 18 as a territory of Australia. Norfolk Island does not have diplomatic representation abroad, or within the territory, and is also not a participant in any international organisations, other than sporting organisations. The flag is three vertical bands of green, white, and green, with a large green Norfolk Island pine tree centered in the slightly wider white band. Constitutional status. Norfolk Island was originally a colony acquired by settlement but was never within the British Settlements Act. It was accepted as a territory of Australia, separate from any state, by the Norfolk Island Act 1913 100, passed under the Territories Power Constitution Section 122 and made effective in 1914. In 1976, the High Court of Australia held unanimously that Norfolk Island is a part of the Commonwealth again. In 2007, the High Court of Australia affirmed the validity of legislation that made Australian citizenship a necessary qualification for voting for, and standing for election to, the Legislative Assembly of Norfolk Island. The Government of Australia thus holds that Norfolk Island has been an integral part of the Commonwealth of Australia since 1914, when it was accepted as an Australian territory under Section 122 of the Constitution. The island has no international status independent of Australia. Norfolk Island has had a limited form of self-government, established by the Norfolk Island Act 1979-100. This limited form of self-government has since been replaced by the Norfolk Island Advisory Council. Much of the self-government under the 1979 legislation was repealed with effect from 2016. The reforms included, to the chagrin of some of the locals of Norfolk Island, a repeal of the preambular sections of the Act, which originally were 3 to 4 pages, recognising the particular circumstances in the history of Norfolk Island consistent with the Australian position. The United Nations Decolonisation Committee does not include Norfolk Island on its list of non-self-governing territories. This legal position is disputed by some residents on the island. Some islanders claim that Norfolk Island was actually granted independence at the time Queen Victoria granted permission to Pitcairn Islanders to resettle on the island following reforms to the status of Norfolk Island. There were mass protests by the local population in 2015. It was reported that Norfolk Island was taking its argument for self-governance to the United Nations. A campaign to preserve the island's autonomy was formed, named Norfolk's Choice. A formal petition was lodged with the United Nations by Jeffrey Robertson on behalf of the local population on 25 April 2016. Various suggestions for retaining the island's self-government have been proposed. In 2006, a UK MP, Andrew Rosendell, raised the possibility of the island becoming a self-governing British Overseas Territory. In 2013, the island's last Chief Minister, Lyle Snell, suggested independence, to be supported by income from fishing, offshore banking and foreign aid. Immigration and citizenship. The island is subject to separate immigration controls from the remainder of Australia. Until recently, immigration to Norfolk Island, even by other Australian citizens, was heavily restricted. In 2012, immigration controls were relaxed with the introduction of an unrestricted entry permit for all Australian and New Zealand citizens upon arrival and the option to apply for residency. The only criteria are to pass a police check and be able to pay into the local health scheme from 1 July 2016. The Australian migration system replaced the immigration arrangements previously maintained by the Norfolk Island government. Australian citizens and residents from other parts of the nation now have automatic right of residence on the island after meeting these criteria. Immigration Amendment No. 2 Act 2012. Australian citizens can carry either a passport or a form of photo identification to travel to Norfolk Island. The document of identity, which is no longer issued, is also acceptable within its validity period. Citizens of all other nations must carry a passport to travel to Norfolk Island, even if arriving from other parts of Australia. Holders of Australian visas who travel to Norfolk Island have departed the Australian migration zone unless they hold a multiple entry visa. The visa will have ceased, in which case they will require another visa to re-enter mainland Australia. Non-Australian citizens who are permanent residents of Norfolk Island may apply for Australian citizenship after meeting normal residence requirements and are eligible to take up residence in mainland Australia at any time through the use of a confirmatory residence visa. Subclass 808. Children born on Norfolk Island are Australian citizens as specified by Australian nationality law. Non-Australian citizens who are Australian permanent residents should be aware that during their stay on Norfolk Island they are outside of Australia for the purposes of the Migration Act. This means that not only will they need a still valid migrant visa or resident return visa to return from Norfolk Island to the mainland, but also the time spent in Norfolk Island will not be counted for satisfying the residence requirement for obtaining a resident return visa in the future. On the other hand, as far as Australian nationality law is concerned, Norfolk Island is a part of Australia, and any time spent by an Australian permanent resident on Norfolk Island will count as time spent in Australia for the purpose of applying for Australian